Introduction to IBM watsonx Orchestrate. What is IBM watsonx Orchestrate? watsonx Orchestrate is an IBM product that allows people to easily create and deploy assistants that help you automate your business operations. It has two main elements. The first element is an automation framework. The automation framework allows you to connect to third-party applications or any applications that can interact with an API and create complex automations that triggers functionality with those applications. The second element of watsonx Orchestrate is the conversational framework. This allows users to create conversational experience and interact through natural language, so users can trigger the automations through simple conversations. When you combine these two elements, you can automate simple tasks, you can create complex workflows that introduce logic to it and can integrate or coordinate actions within multiple applications. You can also automate approvals. Basically, you can automate any business process using a conversational experience. You can create assistants, which can be seen as an entity that is an expert in a particular domain, and they can help you or answer questions about that particular domain. You can also create retrieval augmented generation applications, configuring watsonx Orchestrate to use the power of an LLM to answer a particular set of questions. Finally, you can create agents. The agents can be seen as the evolution of digital assistants. An agent allows you to reroute the conversations and interact with multiple assistants. Now let's talk about the automation framework. The first element in the automation framework are the third-party applications. watsonx Orchestrate has a long catalog of applications you can interact with. But even if you don't see your application in the catalog of watsonx Orchestrate, you can still create new integrations with applications if your applications has a set of APIs. The next elements are the skills. Skills can be seen as a basic functional unit within an application. Each application has its own set of pre-configured skills. And so using the skills, you can access the functionality of your apps. The next element is the skill flows. The skill flows is a sequence of steps that have been created by users. And this allows you to create more complex workflows. Within a skill flow, you can reference the skills and you can use the skills from different applications and combine them to create workflows. So how do you access the skills and the skill flows you created? Within watsonx Orchestrate, you can create a team. But before the team can access the skills or the skill flows, you have to create connections to the apps. The connections will store the credentials or API tokens that you need to have in order to authenticate against your application. And you can set up connections that are the same for the entire team, or you can also set them at the individual level. So every person will be acting with their own set of login and credentials. Once you have set up connections to the apps, then the skills and the skill flows become visible to the team. And how do you use them? Well, you use a conversational interface. So you can say something like edit record X, and the AI agent will understand your request, identify the best skill or skill flow for that particular request, and come back with the appropriate answer. Now, let's talk about assistants. Assistants in watsonx Orchestrate can be seen as a conversational entity that has been configured to help you with a particular domain of requests or tasks. Within the assistants, the basic component is called actions. Actions combine a set of utterances with a particular task and produce a particular result. With an assistant, you can create multiple actions. And you have to be careful so the utterances are different enough between the actions and there is no ambiguity. But adding multiple actions into an assistant, you can create powerful conversational experience that can help people perform automated tasks. What are the type of tasks that an action can invoke? An action can connect to an LLM and use your native AI to implement RAG experiences, right? So you can set up your LLM, create your prompts, and the LLM will take care of understanding the question or the request and coming back with the appropriate answer. You can also invoke as a task a skill flow. Remember in the previous slide, we were talking about how in the automation framework, you can create complex sequence of steps, and these are called skill flows. So actions can also trigger these skill flows. Or you can also create your own custom flow. So let's say you want to perform certain type of functionality with information that has been provided by the user in the conversational interface, but this doesn't involve necessarily any skill. So you can put all the logic within the action. Now, once you have created the actions, you can interact with the assistant through conversation. So let's imagine this user says, how do I perform some task? The AI will look in the catalog of actions and come back with a response. And you can continue this conversation, and the AI will continue to look into the actions and determine what is the most appropriate answer based on the items included in the action. Now let's talk about the AI chat. The AI chat is the default AI agent you can use in Watson Orchestrate. Within the AI chat, you can define a set of instructions that control the behavior of the chat. So you can say you're going to be an expert in this particular area, and I want you to respond my questions in this fashion. And then you connect your AI chat to one LLM. The LLM will help the AI chat understand the questions and generate the right answers. Then you configure the AI chat to have access to skills or skill flows that you've created in your automation framework. And finally, you can also configure the AI chat to have access to other agents. When you connect an agent to the AI chat, you have to provide important metadata that is going to describe what the agent does. So you explain what is the domain of the agent, what are the features of this agent, the scope of this agent, and the purpose of this agent. And using this metadata, the LLM will understand whether it makes sense to reroute the conversation to that particular agent. So now let's see how this works. In our example, someone saying that they want to get onboarded. So the AI will use the LLM to understand the sentence here and will look at all the skills, the skill flows, and agents. And if there is one that matches the request, then it will use it and trigger it. Now the AI will handle that. It will trigger that particular skill flow. In this case, the onboard skill flow. So now let's imagine our user says, I have a question about payroll. Again, the AI agent will use the LLM to understand if this matches any skills or skills flows. And in this case, it will identify the payroll, this particular word, is something that is mentioned in the purpose of one of the agents. And so it knows now that the most appropriate response is to reroute this conversation to one of these agents. When that happens, it comes back with an answer there, suggesting to the user to reroute the conversation. And if the user agrees with this, then the conversation will now be handled by that agent. But it can go back to the AI chat once the conversation has been completed. So now let's talk about a third way of interacting or identifying the functionality we want within the AI chat. This is an explicit naming convention. So if you know the name of the skill or agent or skill flow you want to use, then you add the symbol at and then mention the name of that function that you want to call. So in this example, our user says add approve request X. So again, the AI will invoke the LLM to understand the questions. It will identify there is an explicit request or explicit name used in the request. It finds the appropriate skill flow to trigger, and then it comes back with the appropriate answer that that particular skill flow triggers. So up until now, we have been using all this functionality within Watson Orchestrate only. And so you will have to have created users so they can use the AI chat within Watson Orchestrate. But what if you want to provide this functionality outside of Watson Orchestrate? For example, in your own website, then you can do that as well. To do that, you have to go to the configuration of the AI chat. And there is the option to set up encryption, so all your communications are encrypted. And then you can produce an HTML snippet. This is written for you in Watson Orchestrate, so you don't have to write this code. And you just have to fill out some values that are specific to your AI chat instance. Then you go to your website HTML code and copy that snippet and put it within your HTML code. And then you're ready. So when people go to your website, they will see a new element in the bottom right corner. And if you click on it, this will trigger the conversational interface so people can interact directly with your agent. This concludes the introduction to watsonx Orchestrate.